Hey everyone, this is Erica Sabo. Welcome to another episode of My Bit. Hey everyone, I hope you are well. I hope you like my new hair. I needed a little bit of a change and yeah, this seemed right. So today I'm going to be doing a review of a game that has just left me on the edge of my seat. A game that I literally cannot stop playing. I tend to say this figuratively towards JRPGs, which are much slower in pace, but this game has been so heart-pounding, so fast-paced, and that game is Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. So let's start. So Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc is a visual novel developed by Spike Chunsoft, also known for the Amazing Zero Escape series like 999 or Virtue's Last Reward. Now what makes this game so intriguing and so unlike the rest is its light, zany persona amidst its serious subject matter. It's just so amazing and so mind-blowing. In Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc, a group of 15 students are invited to a prestigious private school known as Hope's Peak Academy. The students chosen are considered ultimate in some way, whether that's being the ultimate programmer, athlete, fashionista, yes, there's actually a gal in this game, gambler, and so on. What they don't know is that there's a dark conspiracy brewing, trapping these students in the school with no way to escape. Along the way, they are teased and tormented by an adorably unsettling robot teddy bear named Monokuma. He sheds some light on the situation, offering them one way to escape, commit a murder, and get away with it. This is when things get interesting. Story is a big strong point for this game, as it constantly left me feeling intrigued and compelled to unfold the mystery. The more I learned, the more questions that would arise and the more committed I would become. While each of the characters are pretty over the top in their portrayals, this is part of the charm of Danganronpa, and works well with the game's quirky approach. I loved learning more about each of them and catching subtle references here and there. I felt connected to the characters, regardless of whether or not I agreed with their survival methods. It left for some extremely tense moments later on, after building up strong attachments to many of them. Each character has a different archetype that surpasses those face value demeanors for something deeper. The team must work together to solve mysteries, all complex in their own way, in order to solve the biggest mystery of them all. What is this conspiracy? What is going on? Characters like the reserved Kyoko end up becoming one of the most important people in the game, unfolding a touching mystery that will stick with you, whereas Togame's snide, condescending attitude ends up giving way, oddly enough, to such a sympathetic tone. Even though the team eventually learn to independently solve these mysteries, they need each other in order to solve the biggest mystery of them all. Without those different perspectives, certain cues wouldn't be met. I owe it to everyone on my team for that. While there were definitely situations where I guessed the mystery before it was solved, there were still enough twists and turns hidden to make me shake. The gameplay proves itself to be just as chaotic and compelling, merging Persona-esque relationship simulator with Ace Attorney-esque trials. Once a murder has been committed, you must find clues in order to find the killer. Once you have enough clues, then trial mode begins, where you must find contradictions in what your classmates say in order to unleash truth bullets, which is evidence, and use those to quite literally counterattack those words. Trial mode also incorporates a hangman and rhythm game element to the mix as a way to heighten the tension even further, and it does so with flying colors. There were several times when I would be on the edge of my seat, heart pounding as a new confession would unfold. Despite never involving physical brain teasers to leave its players thinking, Danganronpa does a wonderful job of solving mysteries in a very rapid speed yet detective-oriented way. The gameplay may be a bit slower prior to investigation mode, but the uneasy anticipation of the mysteries to come are what will draw you in. And when that moment does come, the experience is lightning fast and knows just how to keep your attention. It's been a while since I've gotten to play a game this zany, this sadistic, and most of all, this entertaining. There's a reason why this game has received so much praise in Japan, and it's something that I feel Western audiences will love. Danganronpa is a game that you need to try at least once just so you can experience the chaos. So I hope you enjoyed my review of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. This game is available on the Vita, and Danganronpa 2 is going to be coming out this fall, so please stay tuned. I'm really happy that this game ended up being so successful that they decided to release second one here. It's too bad that they didn't do a combo pack. I know a few of you were talking about that in the past, but at the same time, I kind of like this wait. I like this little anticipation for something in the fall, and I wholeheartedly recommend you play this game because it is hella fun. It is hella fun. And it's only about 20 hours or so. It's not very long, but it's a very, very engaging trip. It's really something. So I really hope you enjoyed this review. This was really fun to do actually for me because it's such a fun game in general. There's a lot more to the game. There's a lot of collectibles you can get. There's a lot of all kinds of things. There's a lot of New Game Plus stuff you can do too. But it's something that I kind of wanted you to experience for yourself. So let's leave it at that, I guess, huh? So please stay tuned again very soon for another video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all later. Okay, peace.